This is the third video in which we talk about GIS shapefiles and Google Earth Pro. In this video, we specifically discuss using GIS shapefiles in Google Earth Pro with a style template. These videos were made possible by AmericaView, Virginia View, the Virginia Cooperative Extension, Colorado Mesa University, and Virginia Tech's College of Natural Resources and Environment. Funding for this project was provided by the United States Geological Survey under grant number G14AP00002. The contents of this video and the related tutorial are solely the responsibility of the authors and do not represent the official views of the U.S. Geological Survey. Mention of trade names or commercial products does not constitute their endorsement by the United States government. This video accompanies Chapter 2 in a written tutorial titled Exploring Our Planet with Open Source Software. You can find the written tutorial at virginiaview.cnre.vt.edu/education or at americaview.org, Exploring Our Planet. So start by opening Google Earth Pro, go to File, Import, and add the Rivers in Southeast Asia shapefile. When you get this message, Data Import, click on Import All. The next dialog box you get is, do you want to apply a style template to the features? Please click on Yes, we do wish to set a style template. What this allows us to do is set symbology. Now you get the style template dialog box. First, we're going to discuss the set name field. This will set a field that will show in the table of contents. This field is tied to the individual column names. For this tutorial, we want to set this field to name underscore zero, which is the name of each country. Next, click on the color tab. If you choose random colors, don't click OK. I just want to show you what happens when you choose random colors. So here I've had use random colors. What happens is this will assign a different color to each feature. And if you remember from our last video, using GIS shapefiles in Google Earth Pro without a style template, each feature is an individual segment of the rivers within Southeast Asia. Now let's now do set color from field. I showed you what random colors looks like. Let's set color from field. This means what's going to happen is the field that we put in, select color field name, underscore zero, it's going to be colorized or symbolized based on the name of the country. So now how do we set the colors? Under palette, start color, click the box, and what you'll get is you'll get this color palette box. You can select the specific color shown, or then click on the end color. So pick a color to start with, and then pick another color as the end color. And what'll happen then, a range of colors will show in the status bar. Now then the area where it says create subfolders for each bucket, put a check mark in there. What happens when you check the bucket options will open, and then you'll see underneath the bucket options where it has the color palette, okay, I pick start color kind of an orangish, end color cyan, and then under bucket options you can see each one of those colors, an individual color is set for the countries, but there's an empty box next to each one of the country names. The empty box is next to the number 5081. The next box for Vietnam is next to 2783. These boxes are blank right now, and you'll need to type the name of the countries in the boxes so they will be displayed in the table of content. But before you do that, let me show you what happens when you don't type the names in the boxes, and I'm going to show you this over the next couple of screens. Just watch for now. Click on OK when you're done. And as you can see, the file did load. It's sitting under temporary places in the table of contents. Now, if you don't see anything in the map document window after you've clicked OK, then you need to make sure that the box in front of Rivers in Southeast Asia is checked. You can see, okay, great, I have a different color for each of the countries, the rivers in each country. Okay, fantastic. I've done exactly what I wanted to do. But wait, let's expand on the caret in the table of contents. But each of the segments are still listed. They're not listed in aggregate for each country. The country names are showing, but we still have the over 10,000 individual line segments that's listed in the table of contents. So let's go back. Okay, you still have the style template box open. And under there, under bucket options, go ahead and manually type Thailand next to Thailand, Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia next to each one of those. Okay. Don't click OK yet. We want to talk about the next tab in this style template box. We didn't click OK yet because we still have one more tab to discuss, and that's the height tab. Under the height tab, clamp features to ground is the default, and we do want to leave this as the feature we want because, quite frankly, rivers and streams are on the ground. They're not above ground. So we want to leave this is. And then we're going to go ahead and click OK. No, it didn't load into your map document window because you're gotten a window to save your style template. You want to save it because you may want to use the same symbology on another occasion. If you were to start a new map document in Google Earth Pro later and load the Rivers in Southeast Asia file, it's going to load just like it did when we first loaded. You've got to apply a style template. So name your style template something that you will understand later and then click on save. After you clicked on save, it should have loaded into your window, into your Google Earth map. Now, I see it in under temporary places, but I don't see it in the map document window. Why? Remember, under temporary places in your table of contents, it is not checked. So you need to check it. Now you see the rivers in Southeast Asia symbolized by country. And if you expand on the caret in the table of contents, instead of seeing those individual features, the individual line segments by country, it's now symbolized in your table of contents by country. Very big benefit by including the name of the country in that bucket box. You can turn individual rivers on and off, and as you can see in this screenshot, we've turned off the rivers for Laos, and we've turned off the rivers for Cambodia. The rivers for Thailand and Vietnam are still on. But say you don't really like the symbology that you did. The color for each of those individual countries are still close, too close, and you really can't distinguish between them, and you want to change the colorization. No, you don't have to go back through the same process and go to style template. What you do is right click on the name of the country for which you want to change the symbology and go to properties. Then what you get is you get the edit folder box and you want to click on the style color. Click OK. You get this for Cambodia. I had right clicked on Cambodia. And then in the color window, click on that box. You get your color palette. You can click the color that you want to choose to symbolize. Click OK. And what happens is we just made the rivers in Cambodia a dark blue instead of that cyan blue. Okay. Now, suppose you'd like to have a file for just one country. Well, you're going to do the same thing that you did when we talked about KML files. Right click on the name, and in this case, we right clicked on the name Laos, then click Save Place As. In this screenshot, I have unchecked the other layer names, the other feature names, Cambodia, Thailand, Vietnam, but you don't really need to uncheck all the other features seen in this screenshot. You just right-click on the name of the feature that you want to export into its own file. Click Save Place As. You'll be taken to this window where you want to save your individual file. And notice it's going to be saved as a .kmz. Name it. I named it Laos Rivers. You don't need to name it that. You can name it whatever you want, but whatever you name it, make sure you remember what that name is. And then once you clicked OK, Google Earth Pro adds it back into your map. It's listed in the table of contents, and it's showing in the map document window as an individual file. But more importantly, it is now available as an individual file that you can use in future maps. This ends our video on using GIS shapefiles with a style template. There are many other options you can explore, but you will do that on your own. If you have any questions with regards to this video or the accompanying written tutorial, please contact Dr. Tammy Parise at Colorado Mesa University or Dr. James Campbell at the email addresses shown on the screen.